joined us all the way from Norway, come over to talk to our friends in the Lehigh Valley. Sissel, thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate your time and being here. Are we having fun yet?
Yes. Well, we're starting. We're just starting now, aren't we?
We're so delighted for you to come and share your talents with the folks of Lehigh Valley. And this benefit concert for members only of Lehigh Valley PBS really is a special thing that you've just created specifically for public television. Tell us a little bit about it.
Well, it's going to be a concert that is a little bit what you're going to see in this concert on here on PBS. And it's going to be something that's a little bit different what you see here as well. But I'm going to bring my prop musicians from Norway, and we're gonna have strings, the string orchestra, and two backing vocalists, and we're gonna have a beautiful time, a beautiful concert that we're gonna create specially for you. And it's gonna be wonderful. I think so. I'm very much looking forward to it.
And we're very. Why do you feel so devoted to public television?
Well, public television for me is quality programming. And I would also say that for me as an artist, to be represented, or like PBS make this special about me as an artist, is something that no other station does, no other TV station does that, because I fall a little bit on the side, I don't get any much radio play, and you know, I'm not an MTV or VH1 artist, so that PBS make this special is something that, you know, I mean, I just had to say yes. I was so happy that they wanted to do this and help me. And I mean, you have so many other artists from Europe, so PBS is really something that
you like. I mean, I've heard you described as a chameleon. I mean, you like it all. You do it all.
Well, I've done all kinds of music since I was a little kid, actually, and that's just because I enjoy so much singing different types of music. Of course, I think out of the voice, first of all. I have to like it, and it has to suit my voice. But I have worked with so many different artists, and I really enjoy it so much. I mean, it's the joy of singing that sort of carry me through what I've done. And I think that I will first of all look at myself as a pop artist, but since I've done so much a variety of music, it affects the way I do the pop. So that's why it's a little bit hard to put me in a pop box, if you put it like that.
Right.
So, but I'm enjoying so much to sing. So that's what I'm doing. I'm just enjoying singing. And well, I met Placido at the Lillehammer Olympics. We were singing in 94. We were singing the Olympic theme song together of that year. And then we started working more together. I joined him the same year for Christmas in Vienna. And last year I joined him on a Sacred Song album where we did duets together. And we'd just done Christmas concert in Moscow this year, or last year it was. And I mean, he's such a wonderful man. I mean, he's a great artist. Everybody knows he has a great voice, but I mean, to be standing next to him and singing with that voice, I have to pinch myself, because it's you know, I just float on top of this beautiful voice, and it makes it so easy to sing. And he gives so much of himself when you work with him, so he's such a wonderful artist to work with.
You're so modest. Yeah, I mean, he heard you sing and wanted to perform with you, and that is no small compliment coming from Placido Domingo. So, it's exciting, I'm sure, for you, and so delighted to be able to do that. And so many other people that we're familiar with on public television, Josh Groban.
Yes.
How was that?
Well, we performed when Jimmy Carter got the Nobel Peace Prize in Oslo. Actually, we were singing in the same venue that this concert is from, Oslo Spectrum. And, I mean, Josh Groban, he's such a wonderful person, and I think he's a great artist, he has a great voice, and I really want to work more with him, actually, because I really enjoyed it so much. He's such a great artist, and hopefully we will. I don't know, but I really want to.
It seems like your star is just continuing to rise and shine here in the United States, just starting to come on board and understand how amazing you are. And probably it was your experience working on the Titanic soundtrack that really might have opened people's eyes up here in the United States to you. Tell us a little bit about that experience.
Well, The composer of the score, James Horner, he wanted a special kind of voice. Well, he wanted a special sound of voice for his score. Like, he wanted to use the voice as an instrument to follow the whole movie. And he came across one of my Norwegian albums where I sang a very specific Norwegian hymn. And he called me and asked if I wanted to come to LA and listen to the themes that he had written, and I immediately fell in love with it. I mean, we were sitting in this huge studio and he was playing this grand piano. I was like, wow, this is breathtaking. And I said, I would love to sing this. And he said, yes, okay, great, we start working. So, yes, and I mean, to be part of such a huge success and be part of that project was, I mean, it was so wonderful. I learned a lot. I mean, to use your voice as an instrument, not only singing with words, but singing just wah, it's something that's, it's a challenge, because you have to get the expression, the emotions, you have to get that through anyway. So that was a real challenge, and I really enjoyed every minute of it.
Okay, you have to. You knew where I was headed down this path. Can you give us just a few bars now, just a little bit of it?
Okay, I'll try.
I'm just going to bring up my friend, you know, well, her friend, Dolly Parton. Tell me about that.
Well, I don't know her personal, but I've been a great fan of her since I was a little kid. And when we're going to do this concert, I've never sung any country western song before. And I was going to have all these different guests. There was this Swedish folk band, and I had two tap dancers from Canada. And I said, what on earth are we going to do together? And then suddenly I came across this bluegrass album that she released, called Little Sparrow, and I found this great song, Marry Me, and I said, this is the song. Now I have the opportunity to sing a country western song. I can't let that go. So that's how that ended up.
And you sing everything. Country. Now, who would think that you can sing opera arias, pop music, and you throw in a little bluegrass just for the fun of it?
Yeah.
I mean, you do it all.
Yeah, but, you know, it's fun. It's in the joy of singing, the joy of working with other artists, and, you know, just be together and have great fun.
And so, you are all about fun, I can tell. People want to know how you got started, Sissel. How did it all begin? You were very young. You're still very young, but you were much younger even when you got started.
Well, I started singing in different children's choir when I was about 9. And when I was around 11, I joined this talent competition, but I didn't tell my parents. But in the end, I have to ask my father to drive me to this place, and his reaction to that I was going to join a talent competition was that, Sissel, what on earth is she doing at a talent competition? Can she sing? So in a way, they you know, my parents, they never compared me with anybody, so they thought, well, Sissel, she's just singing at home. But it started rolling, and I joined the television program where I was singing, got some solo parts, and suddenly when I was 16, I was a professional singer. I was still working at school, but doing my school, but it just went on. So I started young, but just did it because I loved singing. That's all.
So it never felt like work. Even though at 16 years old, you were holding down a full-time job.
No, I never thought of that. I never thought of that as work, because it's so fun. It's so much joy in the singing. That's what, you know, that's an important thing.
Right. How's the United States audience compared to the folks in Europe?
Well, how should I explain this? My experience is that, first of all, they come along, and some of the venues that I've been to, people are just like walking around, and suddenly they hear this voice, and they stop, and they sit down, and stay there the whole concert, and that's like, oh yes, people. People like my voice, you know, like my singing. And then at the end, some of people go, woo, 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 woo. So I guess that's very typical American, I would say.
They make more noise here in the United States than in Europe.
Yeah, a little bit more noise, I would say. In Europe, though, and back home, they're more clapping, you know. And some people cheer as well, but they don't do much of that, you know.
Oh, see, that was me, though, when you said just a little bit ago.
Yeah, you did that.
That's me doing the cat call.
In America, I've joined PBS very much. And what I think is so great for us artists like myself, that sort of we fall a little bit on the side of or what we, you know, get radio airplay or whatever television stations show of music or artists. So when I was asked if I want to do a PBS special, I was so thrilled. I was so happy to be asked because I know you've helped so many European artists earlier. Andrea Bocelli, Sarah Brightman, the three tenors. And I mean, to be part of that European artist coming to America is, I mean, it's an honor, it's a privilege. So I think the PBS is so important for me as an artist, but also for people. I guess people need that kind of television today, especially today.
Even with all the many channels and options that there are here in the United States, public television has always been a safe venue for children, an exciting opportunity for classical music and for performance programming such as your concert that we're delighted to be able to bring it to you. And it is run by... Thank you so much for sharing your talents with us. And your repertoire of music is so diverse. What type of artists and what type of styles have inspired you? You seem to like it all.
Well, yeah, I do. Well, first of all, I look at myself as a pop artist. But I have, I really enjoy singing so many different types of music and listening to different types of music. So, I mean, when I get so much tempted by all this classical, a little bit of classical and a little bit of pop music, ethnic music, I can't help it. And for me, when I was going to do this special for PBS, I thought that I really wanted to show the viewers, I wanted to show the people what really inspires me and what I like to do. Classical is kind of, it's extra music, it's kind of my hobby. And of course, that influenced me as well. So my pop music has a little bit of everything in it. So I guess, that's me, in a way.
That's great, and it shows in your music, and you just tell how much you love it. And I was talking to you a little bit and asking you about your hobbies, and maybe it's a certain style of the music that might be one of your hobbies, because singing is your hobby and your profession and so much of what you love, but you dabble in
what is it?
Country and Western and a little bit of bluegrass, and so, you know, who knows, maybe that's your hobby.
Well, I think it is. I always have a problem when people ask me, what's your hobby? Well, I don't know, because I guess the different styles of music is my hobby, more or less, you know. I guess that's what it is.
And you are so delightful to be around, and I'm sure it just comes across on the air through the concert what a real entertainer you are, that you love people, and the energy that you give off is really incredible. But you're so proud of your roots and growing up in Norway, and some of the beginning of this segment actually talked about a Norwegian folk song that you had, and tell us a little bit about that. Tell us a little bit about your upbringing, how it's different than the United States.
Well, I'm not brought up in America, so I don't know much about the difference, but I've been there so much. But for me, coming from Norway, that's such a small country. Being in Norway and traveling around in Norway, it's like comforting. I feel home wherever I come in Norway. And of course, there's one thing for every people who have traveled in Norway, it's the nature that sort of come to them immediately, because the nature, it has such a strong impact on everybody in Norway. And as I told earlier in the concert, that I mean, I brought up with the nature. We went on hiking every weekend. It was like, it was a natural thing. And of course, I love the Norwegian folk music, and that's also part because I love the nature. I think there is a strong combination there, because I just can't help loving both of them. So I get this very strong feeling for Norwegian folk music as well, the ethnic music.
Will you give us a little bit, just a little bit of that Norwegian style?
Yeah, I can. There is a song that is about the spring. The spring, the water, or the waterfall, and the fiddle. And it's you told me that it's been pretty cold here.
It's been a pretty long winter. So wouldn't you like to hear a little about spring?
This is the Norwegian, kind of a little bit touch of the Norwegian spring. And it goes like this.
Thanks so much, Reg. So many people in the United States became got their first introduction to Sissel thanks to the soundtrack from the movie Titanic. She did everything but the title track on that program, and it was such an amazing, I mean, everyone was moved by that music, and the voice is so beautiful, but we hadn't seen the face, and how beautiful you are, and it matches the music, and how did you get involved in that?
Well, James Horner, the composer of the score, and he came across one of my Norwegian albums, and then he heard one specific Norwegian folk song or hymn, and he just called me up and said if I wanted to come to LA and meet him. And I remember I came into this huge studio and we sat by the grand piano, and he said, could you please hum these few lines, because it's something I've been writing and I would just want to hear you sing them now, because he had been thinking of my voice when he wrote this themes, and I just immediately fell in love with these beautiful lines, and I was like, I remember I got goosebumps, that would you say?
Goosebumps.
And I was like, wow, this is fantastic. And I remember we recorded it in the studio with the movie. I saw the movie because I was not going to sing any words. So that was very important for me to see what kind of emotions I was going to express with my oohs and ahs and you know. And that was, I mean, I was crying. Sometimes I just had to stop singing and said, could we please hold a little minute, because it was so emotional. I thought it was so wonderful.
Oh, and it came across so incredibly to everyone across the globe. So many people just felt it. And it was amazing. You mentioned to me that you used your voice like an instrument, and so many people don't think of it that way, but it really is what it was for that, with no real words to sing.
Yeah, that's true. It was really a big challenge for me that I really, really enjoyed very much that I was asked to do. I mean, James Horner is a wonderful man to work with, and I enjoyed every minute of it.
Now, is that something that people might be able to hear you sing in the Lehigh Valley concert?
I think so, yeah.
You know, so many things.